Hey programmers, today's grandMA3 for grandMA2 programmers topic is networking, and we're going to take a look at three windows related to that. We'll still use sessions to connect consoles, processor units, and everything. We still have sACN and Artnet. It's just that some of the interfaces have changed. So let's take a look. Most of the things that we'd find under network in the setup menu of the grandMA2 are now in the menu. We're going to concentrate on network, DMX protocols, and output configuration. We'll start with network. I got into this window with the menu key, but you can also touch the network icon to the right of the command line. On the left, we're in the Stations tab. This window is most similar to the MA2 network control window. But at the top, instead of two columns showing me sessions and stations, it's just rows of stations plugged into the network. In this example, I've got my on-PC in the same network as my MA3 Lite, but not yet in session together. Each line will show which session each station is logged into, or if it's standalone. One of the changes here is that our master consoles have new titles. A master, as we remember it, is now a global master, and every other console networked to the master is still referred to as connected. Consoles that aren't in a session are listed as standalone, and now we have the title Idle Master, which is used when a console's a master but he's alone in a session. If you have a lot of stations on your network, there's filter options at the top right to help you narrow the list down. Down at the bottom, these session options are pretty close to what we had on the MA2. I can still change my host and session name, along with adding a location. On the right, I've got my MANet interface option, which looks a lot like the station IP from the MA2 network window, but there's a difference here. We're actually configuring an interface. In grandMA3, we have three physical Ethernet connectors at the back of the console, and you can assign MANet, SACN, or Artnet to any of these. So anytime you see the term interface, remember this isn't just the IP address, it's a physical connector on the console. On your console, the connectors will be listed as CON1, CON2, and CON3, and you can pick which physical connector you want to use as the MANet interface from here. If you want to change the console's IP address, you can click it up here at the top, or you can open the My Interfaces pop-up. If any of your connectors are set as DHCP, then it wants to get an IP address from a DHCP server. If that's the case, but you actually want to change that IP, then turn off DHCP, and then you can. You can also change your subnet and gateways here. And now, if you change an IP address, we no longer have to restart the console for it to take effect. If you're using on PC, then your computer's network connectors will be listed here, but you'll want to change your IPs and subnets on your computer's OS, not in on PC. Back in the Stations tab, below the MANet interface, we have an option to connect to a world server. One of the ideas here is that you could create your own world server and be able to connect to your station over the internet. Right now, there's only MA Lighting's world server, and this is a place where they could collect crash logs and also send chat messages so that they can better the software. As of the time of this video, their world server was not currently online yet. Under there, we've got two options that relate back to our MA session. The key is a hexadecimal password for the session. There's already a default, and if you want to make your own, go into Keys on the left. That option is new, but the last option is familiar. It's our master priority, which is like station priority on grandMA2. Options are never, very low, low, normal, and high. There's also a slot number assigned to each station based on the order that they join the session and the type of station that they are, for example, a console or a PC. This will come into play if two consoles are set to the same priority and one drops offline. When it comes back, priority will be given to the console with a lower slot number. If you're looking for the Start Session button, it's this power icon here. It'll turn green when you're in session. You can also see the status of a session based on the color of this network icon by your command line. Red when it's standalone, black at startup, gray when it's an idle master, blue when it's a global master, and green when it's connected. On the left, we have familiar options that work just as we remember. Invite or dismiss a station, join or leave a session. I'm going to click on my MA3 light and invite him. If you're looking for invite enabled, that's going to be this invite toggle here on the right. There's also a web remote option that we can enable or disable here. Next, let's look at the output configuration menu, which is pretty similar to a window that we had on the grandMA2 called network configuration. Let's hit menu and pick output configuration. Just like grandMA2, we can change the output of the physical DMX ports in the back of our consoles here. We can also set SMPTE and MIDI timecode slots. If we change the columns to full, you can see all of the merge and priority options for when you set your DMX ports to be inputs. Lastly, I want to look at one more window, so from menu, I'll pick DMX Protocols, which is where you'll find options for Artnet and sACN, much like the Network Protocols window of the grandMA2. For either type of output, you can pick your interface and set an IP, and also enable and disable the inputs and outputs. In the data section at the bottom, there's all the columns we expect from our Artnet configurations in grandMA2, and there's now a nodes tab to show Artnet devices on the network. It's all the same idea with sACN, except this second tab is called Discovery. Next time, we're digging into user profiles. See you then.